how Rod Hayes and Young Elder study together.
Yeah.
When you want to know something and I'm trying to explain it, this is what it looked like when I'm having you pulling up your references in real time.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Now you see the energy going into his arms.
Yeah.
Now it's another picture that showed the energy going through the whole body.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But if you look, you see it's a yin cycle, yang cycle.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. It says
right. That's masculine, feminine, electric, and magnetic.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right. So practice with a tree to absorb tree energy and then return it to the tree. This is a form of grounding.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The trees are rooted into the earth. When you link to the tree, every family had one.
Uh-huh.
They used to be big oak trees in the south.
Uh-huh. Yeah, okay, go ahead.
Every family yard had a big ass oak tree in the front yard.
Mm-hmm.
At every family gathering at Big Mama house, we would all go to the tree like this throughout the day. Different people, whenever somebody not there, somebody else would go to the tree and rub it and show their respects to the Mother Earth through that tree. And it was symbolic of the family tree.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right, but somebody cut all our trees down on purpose.
Damn, you're right.
Right. So now the question then is, who and what are you?
Mm-hmm.
You are a spirit being in a three-dimensional fixed position reality, experiencing life as the physical body, but at the same time refining your ego to facilitate higher consciousness, what they call ascension.
Uh-huh.
Once the ascension takes hold, you become a God-formed being in human body.
Mm-hmm.
Once you become God-formed, all of this information we just went over is as elementary shit to you.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So we know what we are.
Mm-hmm.
We are a neutron star. That's what a light body is. It's the same energy as a neutron star, the biggest star.
Mm-hmm.
But its step-down capacitor is the mitochondrial that regulates how much of the energy that's going to be able to activate in the DNA in order for your experiences to become heightened and for you to become at a heightened sense of awareness.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If you do your self-work, clean your filters. What's your filters? The body filtration system, your biggest filter is your liver.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right. So what do we do to clean the liver? Dandelion, mm-hmm. burdock root,
mm-hmm.
and milk thistle.
That's right. That's right.
Right. Now, the next thing you have to do is flush the kidneys. That means a water fast for 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
As much water as you can drink in 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And what's going to happen is flushes your kidneys. It gives your kidneys a rest. Right, and it helps to get the impurities out the body.
Mm-hmm.
What's your other filters? Your intestines, your digestive tract.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Once you start breaking, cleaning your liver, it's going to start the process of filling the intestines with the proper bile or enzymes in order to clean your digestive tract of the muck that's built up because you never cleaned your liver before.
Mm-hmm.
Once the intestines then become filled with the enzyme, then you have to cleanse the intestine,
mm-hmm.
right? So we use ground pumpkin, mm-hmm. Clove,
black
ginger, ginger, and we eat a lot of cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
Right, all of that is to soothe the stomach, cleanse the stomach. And then we need, what's this stuff called?
You ever heard of Castor Gugreta? I think I'm saying that right. I think that was one that Dr. Sabi used to clean the intestines.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now, once those are clean, your filters, you're going to automatically feel a lot better. Once your intestines is clean, then you're going to have to start learning to fast because fasting gives you control of your emotional self.
Mm-hmm.
Once you got control of your emotional self, your downs are not so down no more. You can't become suicidal. Right? Now, one of the things that we got to start teaching the children, and this is important for their mental health, early age, early as possible. The harder life is, the bigger your calling is. Right? That just means that you're missing something. It only get hard when you're taking the test.
Okay.
The training for the test and the rewards after the test is before and after the hard part. My mama used to tell it to me like this. I'm so glad trouble don't last always.
Yeah.
Right? What that means is that when you're going through something that's difficult, know that just because you picked in your book of life, and which we're going to do a show on how to read your book of life step by step. But once you understand that you picked in your book of life a hard path because you're one of the strongest ones, right? Because that means it's going to take more to wake you up in the matrix in the 3D than it's going to take a weaker person. You more resistant. You what they call a rebel, a rebellious motherfucker.
Yeah.
Incorrigible. But when you got it, you got it. Right? So we've set our children up for failure by not teaching them that life is supposed to get hard sometimes. Right? If they know that ahead of time, you preload them to be strong through the hard parts. Right? So let's go to the Q&A. We're going to do about 15, 20 minutes of Q&A, and then we're going to cut out.
Hey, man, if you like I say, I posted out the Cash Apps in the link, man. You want to show some love, show some love. Now, if you got any questions for the brother Rod Haynes, you want to drop them in the chat right now, man. I'm looking at the chat right now. I see most people just saying that you right on time. It said Bobby Hendrick was talking about this. What kind of clove? I think I think you can use red clove. That's one of the I got red clove over there.
But you can use all of them is for the same thing. They just do it different purposes.
Okay. Ground clove. All right. Which PPQ to take? Which PPQ that stuff we looked up?
PQQ. Yeah. You got the one that got the highest milligrams.
Okay.
That's the one you're going to look for. I was saying, like, I got a herbalist that I go to, Doc Pitt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whenever I need something, I tell him what I need and he bring it through. We're supposed to be doing a health seminar here in Pontiac coming up next month.
Okay.
Me and Doc Pitt and Max Main from Max Out Fitness. So for anybody that want to know about some health stuff, follow Max Out Fitness on Facebook. And I think he on Instagram and Pontiac. And then you'll see when we're going to do the health thing that he want to do.
Okay. They asking about when we gonna hook up with Dave Calloway.
We waiting on Dane.
Yeah. I think the brother Rod is already in contact with the brother Dane, but it seemed like when I call brother Rod or when he called Dane, it's like our phones start doing some funky stuff, man. I'm telling you, we talk like about 30 seconds and then the phone just all of a sudden just hang up out of nowhere. I'm like, man, what the hell? Then try to call him back, it's blocked. So I was like, what the heck going on with it? Can you speak more on the DNA when you become a mother?
So the energy from the mother, from the DNA, it turns up the mitochondria. You ever notice that the women that's pregnant have a certain glow that only pregnant women have? Their portal is directly open to source to download the light body into the physical form of the developing child in the womb. And when this happens, the side effect is it ramps up the mitochondrial, which gives you a beta endorphin, oxytocin response in the brain throughout your pregnancy. So by the time the baby comes about, you will be in a right energy field. Well, we call it the mother energy, right? The mother energy is unconditional love. The only people that ever gonna really love you unconditionally is your mama. Everybody else has gotta be a condition attached. When a man find a woman that love him the same as his mama gonna co-sign her. That's gonna be the one you stuck with.
Exactly. That's what happened to me.
Now, they telepathically communicate through the heart chakra.
Mm-hmm.
They use you as a jump station. They talk to each other without seeing each other in your face, behind your back. Mm-hmm. Your mama asks you a question and you answer your mama, but she's really getting another answer to an entirely different question from the chick you dating.
That's right. That's true, man. That's a fact. I know that to be true.
So. Right. So this is why the saying is the son always marry his mama. He don't marry his mama, so to speak. He married a female that love him to the same level that his mama. And his mama is the one going to sign off of it, whether she physically here or not.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. That's why the pair bonding at birth is so important.
That's good stuff. That's true, man. That's the same thing with my wife and my mama. Okay, what if the mother did the man wrong, and what can a good woman do? I don't understand that one.
I don't understand the question.
Yeah. She might have to reword that. What does it mean when you see purple, green, and orange?
It depends. It's contextual. See, I could tell you what the colors mean, but that don't mean that's why you seeing them or why you seeing them in that order. It's variables attached to that like tunes in to directly what it means.
I think he just talked about this question. Do you know about the spiritual significance of the Ben Oak tree?
We were just talking about it.
Yeah, he just talked about the tree. Usually those oak trees in Big Mama's front yard.
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean when people, okay, I read that one already. Can the brother Rob elaborate on the W.H.O. and the amendments? What's with it? I don't get that question. I guess he's saying the who?
The World Health Organization was having a vote on these countries, giving them the jurisdiction to enter into the countries for a medical emergency situation, which I can't say certain words on here, but if a medical emergency situation of a national proportion took place, the vote was to give the jurisdiction to the World Health Organization to lock people down. All that is a scare tactic to get the people to wake up and reclaim their sovereign right as the earthborn and their rights to the earth rights.
Wow.
So as long as we are unaware of who we are and what we are, what times we are in, then we stuck. That's why we did this who and what are you take on the Malachi Z. York information that he put out, which was a reference in the beginning of the video to show y'all the starting point for y'all to come to this. That's the prequel to this. That's what was before. That was the original explanation to our understanding level. This was to go deeper into the sciences of the body to give you a different understanding level. Anyway, so the World Health Organization is only going to be able to take control of people who have contracted with the corporate fiction, because that's the only people that they can use as negotiating and leverage tools. The rest of the people that's not participating in the scam plan, Demick, them people not gonna be They don't have nothing to do with what the World Health Organization doing, and the World Health Organization won't be able to tell them anything because they'll know who they are and who don't have jurisdiction over them anyway. The corporate United States has no jurisdiction to surrender anybody's sovereignty to anybody else. But if we allow them to pretend to still be in power once they already fail, then we are part of the problem and not part of the solution. What else you got, Elder?
They said, what methods do you use when reading books in order to retain the information?
Well, one of the things I did is I used to do memory exercises, right? And but for reading books, the best way to retain the information is as soon as you learn it, teach it to somebody or discuss it with somebody. Because once you discuss it, not only did it come in your eyes, it came out your mouth. You created the information circuit.
Okay. We got, it's like, do you got any predictions on what's going to happen this coming up this summer for the next 2 months, like with June and July?
I'm not a prophet. I don't predict the future.
Okay, y'all got that. He says he's not a prophet. I don't predict the future. It says,
I take this though, if the oracles is reading it, if they miss something, I can see it. Like, if an oracle is reading on what's going to take place over the next couple of months and she's pulling cards, if she missed something, I'll see it.
Okay.
But on my own, I don't read the future. I just tell y'all what I see in real time. And most of the stuff I'm telling y'all, hindsight is 2020. It's easier to see looking back on it than it was when I was learning it.
All right, this is the last question we're going to take right here. It says, yes. how do you make the genetic cleanup? Like they say that, like they, so that they got like, they their parents was a drug addict or anything like that. And it,
so, right. So we talk about shadow work.
Okay.
So any bad trait that was in your family, you're going to be confronted at some point in your life with that bad trait.
Uh-huh.
Yo, ancestors that left that energy in the family tree want you to correct them. And your ancestors that's on the other side with them want you to correct them so they can make them sit their ass down, and that heals the damage to the family tree.
Okay.
So you become the sacrifice for all of the ancestors in the direct procession before you, going back 7 generations. And when you go back 7 generations, the alcoholic gonna pop up, the dope fiend gonna pop up. Some of us are strong enough to say, no, I don't want none of that. But some of us not. That's also an ancestor, right? So you either gonna channel your weak ancestors or your strong ancestors.
Mm-hmm. That's good stuff. That's good stuff, man. So you can alter your DNA, you can alter your genetics if you, by just, you know, just changing your metrics of what you're doing, whatever you're doing that your parents did, change that,
break the patterns.
Yeah, to break the cycles. All right, man. Like I say, man, I shot them cash apps in the link, man. So you want to show us some love, I'm going to post it in the descriptions too, after the video. But me and that Rob Haynes, we're going to be doing this a lot, man. We're going to be doing this a lot. Live research. This is live research because I'm sitting. It's my time to sit with the brother Rob Haynes and absorb his perspective so I can add it to my game, man, because he one of the masters up in this joint, man, the master teacher. The
master student.
Yeah. Hey, master student, master teacher to me, you know what I'm saying? So you like, you giving me.
I'm not disrespecting Baba by taking that title. That's him. As long as he's walking, he's the only master teacher right now.
Yeah, hey, I feel it. But like when I was in college, I set up under a lot of people who had the master's title. Like most of them people that I picked in college were doctors. So I had like 4 or 5 doctors as my, like I had a doctor's in biology when I took biology. I had a doctor's in English teaching. That's how I learned how to write. This one teacher that stayed on me. That's how I learned how to write in English in college. And but they all was doctors. So you could, when you go to college, you sit under different.